Hello, you're welcome once again. We are still looking at basic algebraic concepts and manipulations, and today the concept we want to look at is fractions. Fractions. So we say a fraction is any number of the form. Of the form A out of B. So we know A are variables, they can take on anything. Where we refer to A as the numerator, and B as the denominator. So when we say numerator, meaning anything above that line and denominator anything down. So a fraction would be this. Could be 3 over 4, it could be x out of x plus 1, it could be cos theta out of sine theta plus cot theta. All these are fractions because in this case a is 1, b is 2, a is 3, b is 4, a is x and b is the whole of this. So variables can take on anything, but whenever we say fraction, it's always in this form. Now, many of you think fractions are only this. No. Even these weird things, as long as they take on this form, they are fractions. Now, what's left to do is to understand how to add, multiply, divide, and subtract fractions. And I must say that whatever you learned in your lower levels still applies. So I just want to remind you what to do. Okay. Let's look at addition and the subtraction of what? Of fractions. So to do this, we first get LCM, lowest common multiple of denominators. Now, I know you know what LCM is, but I will keep reminding you. If I have fractions of this nature, it could be adding or subtracting. No problem. So I'm taking plus or minus because we are looking at addition and subtraction. So what we do, LCM. Unknowns of things like this, what you do, you simply take their product that will always work as the LCM. So it is AB. Now we get AB, we divide with that. AB divided by B, you see, remain with D, so you multiply A with D. Plus or minus, again, this divided by this, BD divided by D. The D goes, remain with C. And that's it. Now, each in a simple example, if I have 2 plus 2 over 3, the LCM here is 6. This you already know. Now, 6 divided by that, 6 divided by 2, we get 3. So we get 1 times 3, plus 6 divided by 3, we get 2. So we have 2 times 2, which will be 3 plus 4 over 6, which is 7 over 6. 1 and 1 over 6. This one you know. But now, if we are looking at numbers like this, 3 out of x plus 3 plus 2 over x minus 3, now the problem comes here. You just forget that these are the same. This is done in the same way. Okay? The same thing I'm going to do. First, we say we look for LCM. And I've said LCM of such guys whom we don't know what they are, simply take their product. Okay? So when I take the product of these two, I will have something like this. Now, when I get this divided by x, this is what I mean, x plus 3 into x minus 2, and I'm dividing with x plus 3. You see this cancelling, you make with that bracket, you multiply it with that. And the multiplication here, mean that you're multiplying this row leaving out a negative 2. So the bracket here is very important. Likewise, down here, this product here, you can't say x plus 3 n times x minus 2. This is still wrong. Because what you must say is multiplication first. And so the multiplication guarantees that the multiply the exam shall be leaving out the other ones. Okay, so let's do that. N plus, this is divided by that. Do the same thing. The main is this and have 2x minus 2. Minus 3 plus 3. So when you open this, becomes 3x minus 6 plus 2x plus 6 out of that thing. Down there in the denominator, when you work out that the 6 code means 5x over x plus 3, 2x minus 2. Okay, let's try another example and see what we get. Let's try another example. Now, another example is 1 out of x plus 3 squared minus. Now, if I may ask you, what is the LCM here? Many of you are going to tell me it is 4. Yes, because with numbers, you can easily visualize things. When we have things like this, life is hard. But I can show you that it's the same thing. Because this 4 is the same as 2 squared. So you are taking the one which is having the highest power. So if the two are the same, then you simply take the one with the highest power and ignore it work as our LCM. However, this does not contradict our statement here that when you have two things, just take the product and I will show that it still works. Okay? Alright. So when I get this divided by that, I remain with that. Minus this divided by that, one of them will go. If you see this, one will go and I remain with 2 into x plus 3. When you open that, you have 2x minus 6 out of x plus 3 squared, and this will give us negative 2x minus 5, x plus 3 squared. Now, I was saying if the LCM is now simply multiplying this with this, when you multiply them, you will get cubed. This divided by that, one bracket remains, it's something like this, x cubed plus 3. Over x plus 3 squared. So one of them remains. Then minus this with this, you remain with 2 of the brackets because if this is not there, then we have this. Then you can see. Laws of indices say that since the bases are the same, we shall subtract because this is power 1. And remain with 2x plus 3 into squared. So if you use the wrong LCM, you will need to go through this trouble of factorizing. And so if I say that this bracket is similar to this, I can pull it out. And when I pull it out, here I remain with 1 minus 2 into x plus 3. Something like this. X plus 3. So this can cancel with 1 here. And remain, you now come to this step. Because this bracket is similar to what is in the numerator here, and this and this will be reduced to this. So it still works. If you have any two you don't know, take their product. If you actually know, then use the right LCM. I want to do my final example of this. My final example. I hope that these are clear. I hope they are clear indeed. Okay, my final example is 3 out of 2x minus h plus 1 over x minus 4 plus 3 over 2x. What will be the LCM? Now, what needs to clearly, I have said, you can just feel free to multiply all these together. It still works. But I don't want to do that. What I want to see is I realize that this and this have a relationship. The relationship they have is that if I factorize 2x minus 8, I will get 2 minus 4. Hope you can see that. So this is there. So 4 is already there, the 2 is there, what we don't have is F. So I will take my LCM as this. Because I have catered for everything that is down here. When I multiply these two things inside here, I get that this is already there. Then the 2x is already there. So there is nothing I'm not catered for. But like I said, you can multiply the way they are. Go through the trap of simplifying them. Okay? Alright, so what we do next is to get that divided as that. Remember, this two together with that is that, so we shall remain with x. This is that, remains with 2x. This is that, remains this bracket, and so we have 3 into x minus 4. So we open the bracket, 3x plus 2x plus 3x minus 12, and this becomes, okay, here we don't need to open. When you add this and this and this, 5, 8, 12, x, 2 into x minus 4, x, then you have 2 into 2x minus 3, then you have x into 3x minus 4, and actually n is there. So you can see that even if you multiply, you can as well do that. You can multiply through, you can multiply through all this, and then we redo the question, it will still give us that. Okay? Maybe you want to see that. How it works. I want to show you that as long as your mathematical is consistent, then it should work out. Okay, so my LCM here, I'm going to say 2x minus 8, I'm multiplying with 2x, and I'm multiplying with x minus 4. So divide that with that, you will have 3 into 2x, then x minus 4. Hope you are seeing that, because when I apply the order of this with this, that term will go away. I remain with these two, which I multiplied up. When I divide that, I remain with this 2, 2x minus 8. Then when I divide, I remain with this 2, 3 into 2x minus 8. So you can see this is healthy, but it will work. Why it will work is simple. I can first do this. Let me first show you how. So if I factorize here, I will have 4x into x minus 4 plus 3 into 2x. Okay, I can also have 6x minus 4 by square because they are 2. Then I have 2x. Actually, I can also put here 4. So you see that this one is common, I pull it out. This is 6x, and this is plus 4x, and then that side is 6 into x minus 4, something like this. Then 4x into x minus 4 squared. So already you see one of them will be 1, I will have that. When I try to add these guys, what do I get? This and this is actually 10, 16x minus 24 over 4x into x minus 4. So when you pull out 8, you have 8 into x minus 3, minus, okay, 8, that should be 2, out of 4x into x minus 4. And you can see the 2, this divided by that will give us that. So I will give you some examples, some exercises to try.
You can try out this exercise and can always let me know where you find some difficulties. Thank you.